In this lesson, we're going to talk about how to graph linear inequalities. We're going to look at the epic battle between linear equations versus inequalities. We're going to look at the steps to graph linear inequalities, and then we're going to look at a few examples. All right, so maybe not an epic battle between linear equations and inequalities, but there is a difference, and there are some things that are the same. So take a look at these two. We have an equation here. And we have an inequality here, and we're asked to solve. What are the similarities that you see? They're both looking for solutions. They both have the same constant. They both have the same coefficient. What are the differences that you see? This one is an equation. And this one is an inequality. This one is going to have one solution, that is x equals negative 3. This one, remember we have to flip the inequality because that's a negative coefficient, has many solutions. Anything that is bigger than negative 3 is a solution to this one. Linear equations and inequalities are also similar processes, but there are some key differences. Here are the steps for graphing linear inequalities. Just like in an equation, you're going to solve the inequality for y and use the y-intercept and slope to plot points. Here are some of the key differences. For the line, if it's less than or greater than, it's going to be a dashed line. Because anything that's on the line will not actually be a solution because it has to be less than or greater than to be a solution. If it's less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, it's going to be a solid line because anything that's on the line is a solution to the inequality. And because there are more than just what's on the line, we also have to shade for inequalities. So if it's a less than, you're going to shade under the line, or less than or equal to, you're going to shade under the line. If it's greater than or greater than or equal to, you're going to shade above the line. So for inequalities, we have to pay attention to the kind of line, and we have to shade. The solution set of an inequality includes all the ordered pairs that are in the graph's shaded region, as well as on the line if the line is solid. So here is a linear inequality. Y is less than 2 times x plus 1. And this is what it looks like graphed. And we're going to talk about how to create this graph in a minute. But this is what it is when it's graphed. And you can see it has a dashed line for the border. Because this is a less than and not a less than or equal to, and it's shaded. Everything that's in this shaded area is a solution to this inequality. Everything that's on this line is not a solution to this inequality. Let's pick a point here, like 5, 1. That should be a solution to this inequality. So we put the 1 where the y is and the 5 where the x is. And we get 1 is less than 10 plus 1. 1 is less than 11. That is true, and so that is in fact a solution. But if I pick this point right here, that point is 0, 1, and I put that into this inequality, let's do that over here. 1 is less than 2 times 0 plus 1. 1 is not less than 0 plus 1. 1 is not less than 1. It would only be if this was equal to. So anything on this line that if it's dashed is not a solution. Everything that's in this shaded area is a solution. If it's solid, everything on the line is a solution. Step one, make sure it's solved for y. It is. Step two, draw the line. So we're going to start at 3, 1, 2, 3. That's our y-intercept, and our slope is 1 over 1. So we're going to run 1, rise 1. And what kind of line should it be? There's no line under the inequality, so this is going to be a dashed line because everything that is on this line is not actually a solution. It's just the borderline of our inequality. Now, it's less than, so that means we're going to shade down. And one easy way is to decide which way is down or under is to start at the line and draw an arrow down. That is under the line. It's not so hard here, but as the line gets steeper, it's sometimes hard for students to tell which way is under the line. And so just start at the line and draw an arrow straight down. That is underneath. And this would be the shaded area of that line. And you're done. Let's take a look at another one. First, is it solved for y? Yes, it is. So I'm ready to draw the line. So I start at -4. That's my y-intercept. And then my rise is -2 and my run is 1. So I'm going to run 1, rise 2. In this case, I'm sinking, of course, because it's negative. Oh no, I'm sinking. Always makes me think of the Wicked Witch of the West. I'm melting. Okay, this one has a line under it. So what's on this line is actually a solution. And I should use my straight line tool to create this, but I've created enough dots, I can make it pretty straight. And then it's greater than, so it should be above the line. Can you tell which side is above the line? Is it A or B? That's right, it's A. Again, if you take a line and you draw it straight up, that is above the line. So this side is the shaded region. And that's it for that one. Let's look at a special case. Graph x is greater than 2. So there's no y, so that's a vertical line at 2. And then there's no line under the inequality, so that's going to be a dashed line. On this one, there's no above and under. But think about this. It says x is greater than 2. So where are the x's that are greater than 2? Here's an x that's greater than 2. Here's an x that's greater than 2. So of course, the shading would be on this side. One last example to ponder. If a student graphed 2x plus 3y is less than 4, would the shading cover the origin? So first, let's remember that the origin is 0, 0. And the question is, would the shading be over 0, 0? Well, let's think about what the shading means. The shading means that those are solutions to the inequality. So the question is actually asking, is 0, 0 a solution to this inequality? So without graphing, I can just put 0 in for x and 0 in for y and see if it's a solution. I get 0 plus 0 is less than 4. Is that a true inequality? Is that a true statement? 0 is less than 4? It is. So would the shading cover the origin? Yes, because 0, 0 is a solution. Is 2, 3 in the solution set? Well, the only way to know is to put 2 in for x and 3 in for y and see if you get a true statement. We have 4 plus 9. Is 4 plus 9 less than 4? No. So 2, 3 is not in the solution set. Hopefully you have a little bit of understanding now of what it means to graph linear inequalities.